Chindo.
What is dude? Who the hell is this doofy ass nigga, bro?
Bro, chill.
No, fuck that shit.
Dirty face, I might dirty face. I might fuck his bitch, no Bobby bitch. Bitch, I'm gnarly bitch. I watch that tummy rip, tummy tuck. Fucking uppercut the pussy, shut him up.
What's good, Akafam? How you guys doing today, man? It's a nice little Sunday, you know, enjoying myself on a Sunday afternoon, you feel me? And I just wanted to update you guys, man, on what's going on right now. I just been really chilling today. I just really have been chilling. I've been having a good day today. It's Sunday. Like most of you, I probably, you know, spent it the same way as you guys did. I chill, relaxed, cleaned myself up, cleaned the crib up, cleansed my body with some water and some bread. An all-around cleanse, you feel me? I got my throat back, you feel me? If you watched the footage from yesterday, I re-upped on some plies. But yeah, man, this nigga Chino called me over because he was talking about, oh, I want to talk to you about some woo-doo-woo-woo. Just come over, bro. Just come over here. That's the thing about Chino. This nigga Chino, whenever he want to do something, he try to rush you to get you to do it as soon as possible. Like, he want it done now. Like, this short-ass nigga low-key be like, sometimes I be like, I be forgetting this nigga show this shit and I don't have to listen to him. Do you know what I'm saying? Sometimes this nigga be saying some shit and the way he say it is like this nigga just 6'5". So it kind of like confuses you into like kind of listening to him because this nigga wants to get shit done. I don't know. Chino's crazy, but he talking about he want me to come over. This nigga lives 3 doors down from me, so I'm just going to go and see what the fuck he trying to talk about. So I'm gonna just bring y'all with me. Because you know I just been chilling for most of the day and recovering, you know. So, bow. Damn, nigga, you just stand right next to the door?
No, I was walking over, but I was going to the kitchen.
I'm good with you.
What's good with you?
Where are you going? What's up, man?
Man, what's going on, bro? You gotta tell me. What's up?
What are you talking about?
Man, don't act like you don't know what I'm talking about, bro. I'm trying to change the settings on my camera. I'm sorry. Bro, you know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm talking about? Okay, look, bro.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Look, here's what I'm talking about. I invited you over here because you need to talk.
What?
Oh, fuck. Look, bro. Okay.
What the fuck are you talking about?
First of all, what is the deal, dog? No, bro.
What the fuck was that?
Bro, okay, hold on, hold on. You gotta tell me what is the deal with you and Fight. That's why I called you over, because I was going through my feed and all I keep seeing is... Well, first of all, Fight went over to your mama's house?
Yes, nigga.
I'm sorry to laugh, dog, but I assumed that I was like, what's the deal? So what is going on between y'all? I haven't seen you in the past couple days. I'm trying to figure out... why are y'all arguing, and B, what is this like, where did this like originate from? I hate playing fucking Dr. Phil and shit.
Okay, so basically, long story short.
Yeah, long story short.
Cause I'm tired of talking about this, honestly.
Okay then, well, what's going on?
Flight, me and Flight made a bet, okay, a while back, and I'm pretty sure you're even aware of it. We played 1v1, okay. And we made a bet a while back that me and him, if I win, then...
My bad.
Man, nigga, you dinging and shit.
I'm sorry, I told you, I gotta go do something.
Okay. But we made a bet a while back, and if I beat him in 1v1 on basketball, then... I get to kiss
his ex. Is this on some more childish shit?
Okay, look. It's childish on his part. Okay.
Okay, go ahead. I want to hear how stupid this is.
So basically, he lost the bet. I got to kiss his ex. Okay, but I didn't actually kiss his ex.
Okay. Remember, the last thing I remember is that we were in the whip and y'all were arguing. Is this that same thing?
Yes, but I'm like, I'm telling you where it rooted from. Do you know what I'm saying? Because you asked me where, like, okay.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? So, fucking, it basically, when she was supposed to kiss me, okay, mm-hmm. I had her not kiss me for a prank just to piss flat off. You know what I'm saying? Because I know. You know what I'm saying? Him and whatever him and Diamond had going on, I know he was going to get pissed off if I actually even attempted to do that. Do you know what I'm saying?
So he got,
long story short, he got mad.
But okay? You instigated.
And I instigated.
Of course he instigated.
But
how
I'm,
do you always do that?
But okay, but I'm saying, nigga, like it's... It,
so look, it... So...
The then, type of person I am, I'm not going to let nobody tell me I can't do something. We were at Mitch's house.
Okay.
And yeah. this nigga tried to bitch me out. And tell me not to go over to Diamond's house. Like, I'm really supposed to listen to this nigga. Do you know what I'm saying?
Bro, but there's a difference between somebody telling you, obviously, you like, for an example, there's rules, right? You don't just go out breaking the law, right? You know what I'm saying? It's the same thing. There's, like, guy code. You just stuff you don't do.
My question is to you.
I understand
you. Where did I break guy code? I brought his ex food. She lives in the same building as me and you, nigga.
But all he asked you to do is one simple thing.
Which is what?
Not bring her food.
Nigga, he asked me the second time after I already did it. Now, I understand I could have just stopped taking it. But if you would have asked me on some cool shit like, hey, bro, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know you didn't mean no harm or nothing like that. But, like, could you just not bring flight? Could you just not bring, like, my ex some food? It's just kind of, it bothers me on some bro code shit. Then I'll be like, okay, you know what I'm saying? But the nigga came at me disrespectful, you know? Yeah. Talking about some, oh, you know, you better not go to Diamond's house or else, or this or that. So now you're trying to threaten me, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm sorry, Tino, like, just the way I was raised.
Right. I'm writing all this down.
I'm just kidding, I'm not. I was Texas.
The way I was raised, I'm not going to let no fucking another nigga tell me what I can and can't do. Unless your Z is.
Okay, but he just asked you as a friend to not, you know, out of respect for him and whatever his situation, to not do something, you should just respect him. Be like, nah, I'm not, okay, fine, I won't. And you did it. Just to piss him off.
So you're saying it's my fault, Chino? Is that what you're trying to tell me?
I'm not saying it's your fault.
Look, bro, what you don't understand is flight is literally like
the... I understand on both ends. Flight is being childish about it, and then you are instigating it, making him more upset because you feel like he shouldn't be telling you what to do. Obviously, you can go do whatever the hell it is you want to do.
Right.
You can go rob a bank if you want.
But I'm saying even whatever I did, right? Even whatever I did do. Is it really so bad?
No, you just dropped off food. I just feel, you know, that it's not something you should have done because he asked you not to. So this is all over a basketball game, a kiss that never happened.
But I'm saying this nigga went to my mom's house, bro. Right. My mom's house, nigga. My mom's house, Chino. You're not fucking understanding, man.
I feel you.
This nigga went to my mother's house. He's only been to my mom's house one time. One time, nigga. And that means this weird ass nigga saved the shit. Saved where the fuck I live. When was my comedy show, bro? When was my comedy show?
Last year.
Exactly. And this nigga still has address to my motherfucking mom's house. Who's that?
I don't know.
Chido, what do you do? Who the hell is this doofy ass nigga, bro?
Bro, chill.
No, fuck that shit, bro. You know what we got going on, my nigga?
I know, I understand.
Bro, why do you have this doofy ass nigga in this house, my nigga? What you want right now, bro?
Listen, bro. I invited both of you.
Don't take your backpack off. No, hey, don't.
No,
right
now,
my nigga.
What's all that shit on the internet?
What is going on here, my nigga?
Bro, shut your little fucking retarded ass up, nigga. God damn it. You fucking dated my ex, my nigga. You're fucking flawed, my nigga. What the fuck is wrong with you, bro?
Is this nigga really, bro? You went, bro.
I
ain't got nothing to say to you no more, my nigga.
I don't got nothing to say to you no more, my nigga. You better go. You set me up, my nigga. nigga, you know what's going on. Look, you know the fucking
y'all going on, nigga. Talk this out.
No, bro. Fuck that shit. There's no talk now, nigga. That's enough talking now, nigga. I did that shit enough on the reactions, my nigga. Enough talking now, bro. That's dead. That's dead. What's up?
Just talk.
I'm right here. Fuck the talking, my nigga.
Just talk to him.
No, nigga. I'm right here, my nigga. I'm right here.
Hey, back up now, nigga.
Fuck that shit, bro.
I will really fuck you up, fight. I will really fuck you up, my nigga.
Fire. God damn.
Back up.
Bro,
don't get it fucked up. Nah, hey.
Past weeks,
y'all don't get it fucked up, Flight. I will really, hey, Flight. I will beat your ass, my nigga.
Oh, my nigga, like McQueen. Nigga, I took karate when I was 3. You're not beating nobody's ass.
You took karate when you were 3.
I was 3 years old, my nigga.
That karate didn't help you. Last time I ran your ass over, nigga.
Nigga, I wasn't looking. I wasn't looking. Anybody can get run over when they're not looking. Yeah, you set me up, nigga. What you talking about, nigga? I'll be both y'all niggas' asses right now, bro.
What the
I'll
fuck?
I'll take y'all niggas 1-on-2. I'll take both y'all niggas 1-on-2 and your dog, my nigga. What the fuck is going
you
on?
You have my beef, my dog.
I would take both all y'all niggas 1-on-1 right now, bro.
Fine, look,
you
my
set
nigga.
Me up, my nigga.
Just, I'm letting you know right now, nigga.
It's nothing, you know, nothing, my nigga.
You know what? I'm not even gonna let you know, bro. Keep doing what you're gonna do. Keep doing what you're gonna do. Keep doing what you're gonna do. And stop taking shit off like you really about to do something, my nigga. You're but literally a fucking it, stick, Flight. I will literally body your bitch
nigga,
ass,
don't
my
let
nigga.
The stick fool you, my nigga. It's full of pounds, 90 pounds.
No, you're not, my nigga. You literally weigh fucking 90 pounds, bro. You're literally a 90-pound lizard with tattoos, my nigga.
No, damn. No, bro. Chill for a second.
I'm gonna be waiting outside. No, fuck the comment out, bro. Look, all you set me up, and I'm gonna spare you. You're lucky I'm not leaving. I'm not gonna
leave,
bro. I'm not
get this fucking weak ass nigga out of here, bro.
I'm gonna be on your floor, my nigga. I'm gonna be waiting outside for you. Hold on. You said you had something for me. Come if I take your mom again on a date or come to your house, bro.
Okay, look,
nothing's gonna happen, nigga.
Okay, listen,
I'm here.
Listen.
You're lucky I'm not doing shit right now to mess
look,
up the floor, my nigga.
Look, do it again, Flight. That's all I gotta
bro,
say.
I'm coming to sleep.
Do it again.
I'm coming to sleep, bro.
I'm glad you let me know. I'm glad you let me know. I'm not lucky, nothing, my nigga. I will really beat the fuck out you, Flight. Shut up. Like, shut up, my nigga. You're not gonna do nothing.
Bro, I will leave the stains everywhere on the floor right now, bro.
McQueen, first of all, McQueen, shut the fuck up.
No, look. Bro, like, honestly, bro, you said lose my number.
Yeah, get
lose
the fuck up out of here, my nigga.
If I see you outside, damn, nigga,
you're not gonna do anything.
Bro.
You're not gonna do anything.
Again,
you're not gonna do anything.
Shit,
do that
I'm
shit. I can't wait till you do. I can't wait till you do.
Right here,
I can't wait till you do.
Right here,
I can't wait till you do, bro. I ain't got nothing to say to your ass.
Flight!
Don't let me catch my mom's house, nigga.
Flight!
It's your fucking fault. I don't know why the fuck you did that, nigga. I don't know why.
Fault?
I don't know why the fuck you. Why would you? I know you invited him.
First
over,
of all, you,
I know you did
gosh,
that.
Oh my god!
You do
so
shit
it's
like
my
that.
Fault?
No, it's not. I'm saying, look, you, I know you do shit like that, bro. I know you do shit like
okay,
that.
Okay, but for a good reason. Y'all are. Do you not understand that y'all are acting like
okay,
two little kids fighting over?
But do you see what happened? Do you see what happened, bro? So you called me over. I'm not mad at you. I just know that that's what you do. So I know you didn't just. It didn't just fucking magically. Flight didn't just show up to that.
Flight didn't magically pop up. I brought him over here because y'all need to talk. This is stupid. You not think this is stupid? I'm losing my voice and shit. Look, bro. You guys are arguing over literally.
You got me fucking shaking, nigga.
I see you shaking. Your camera's shaking. You don't think that you're fighting over the dumbest, for the dumbest reason ever. I'm on stream and shit chilling and people are like, yo, bro, what's up with Flight McQueen? I didn't know, bro. I didn't know. And then I started looking into the video.
You can't be putting niggas in that position, bro. Like, I literally...
No, what are
I'm
you...
I'm ready to fight. Like,
for
I'm
what?
Ready...
For what?
What? Nigga, he's the one who came up in here spazzing out like he always
no,
does.
No, I
play
know,
fucking
bro.
2K
you,
or some shit, nigga.
I literally feel like you guys aren't, like, talking like adults.
Look, bro. You saw me standing here. I literally was just
you
chilling. I was doing my thing.
I
was instigating because
yes,
the nigga was coming... Bro, he was coming... But this is the thing you're not understanding, Chino. This is the thing that niggas don't understand. Am I supposed to just sit there and let the nigga talk shit to me?
No, you let A talk, then B talk, and that's it. Y'all work it out.
Okay, but you see how the fuck that went, nigga. You know, first of all, you know Flight is not the type of person that's gonna fucking do that. First, look, man, Chino, all I'm saying is, look, I understand what you're trying to do. But it's that situation. Look, nigga, I told you before you even answer the fucking door, nigga, I was telling you that... How would you feel if someone came to your mom's house and tried to date your mom? How would you feel? Despite whatever the fuck I did, nigga. Is that not going too far?
I don't really know my mom like that.
I understand that, and I'm sorry to bring that up. I'm just saying, bro. Like, think about that. Think about that situation. That's your family member. You know what I'm saying?
I understand, but listen, bro. The core of this is stupid. And so what you guys need to do is be like, look, I apologize for dropping off food. I'll never drop off food again. And he's gonna be like, okay, I apologize for going to visit your mama. I'll never do it again. And that's it. Squash it. There's literally...
Bro,
first of all, that was out of line for flight to go. I'm gonna agree with you.
That's what I'm trying to say, because you're not hearing me when I'm saying all that, bro. Like, I literally didn't even do shit, bro.
I agree.
I literally came over here and just, because you asked me to come over here. Okay.
Look, if both y'all want to take it, if you guys want to take it out on me, I don't give a shit.
I'm not taking it out on you, Chino. That's why I'm not spazzing on you. I'm just letting you know, bro. Like, it's not my fault in this situation. I came over because you asked me to. Then I get put in this situation. Okay.
Okay, but understand from a friend's perspective, seeing two friends fight over some stupid shit, I'm just trying to freaking bring it down a notch, and so that y'all can, you know, get back to normal, because this is stupid. That's all.
All right, just man.
And personally,
I need to calm down. I need to calm down. All right. Because you just put me in this position where I feel like I need to fight now. I'm over here shaking from how much adrenaline I got, nigga. I don't, you know what I'm saying? Like, I had a good ass day today. And I'm not putting that on you, Chino. I want you to understand that, bro. I appreciate it. Like, honestly, I do. But it's like this, it's not gonna work with this nigga fight, bro. He's all not. Right, well, it's either like he gotta realize he acting stupid, or something gonna happen. I'm not gonna say what it is, but something gonna happen. That boy keep fucking around. Something bad is going to happen to him, bro. And you see, you try to even make it work. You try to put us into a position where we can talk it out. Yeah. And this nigga starts, no, I'm not going to act like I'm innocent. I was instigating only because he came in here and start trying to talk crazy right off rip. You know what I'm saying?
No, he was talking crazy to me. But that's not a reason for me to fight. I have nothing against Flight just because he's like, oh, well.
That's not a comparable situation, dog.
No, I understand. But you see the same thing as basically he's taking his anger out on something. You know what I'm saying? So because he's mad at you, he goes and goes to see your mama and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's definitely out of line. I understand that. That's totally out of line. That's like him trying to take your sister on a date. You know what I'm saying? That's too far. But he needs to apologize for that, which is what I was trying to get at. But he wasn't having it. And you need to apologize for instigating the situation, making him even more mad. So, you guys need to figure it out. There's nothing I can do. I thought if y'all two came through, that you guys could talk it out, but... if you guys can't do that, then you guys are on your
own. I'm gonna just go back to the crib, bro. Alright. I hear everything you're saying, and I don't think you understand that this fight is not he's not the person that you're thinking he is in this situation. He's not gonna be willing to talk. So, but I appreciate. I'm gonna just go, bro. All right, I'm gonna talk to you later.
No, but this is baby girl. It's easy to love me now. Would you love me if I was down and out? Would you still?